Afghanistan. Just hours before America pulled out of the country last month, it got in one final drone strike at a suspected terrorist, you know, for old time's sake. Except now we're learning more about who was actually droned.
That drone strike killed an Afghan working for a U.S. aid group, along with 9 others, including 7 children.
Yes, there are others killed. Who they are, we don't know. But at this point, we think that the procedures were correctly followed and it was a righteous strike.
Okay, maybe we have different dictionaries, but I don't think righteous is the word I would use. If you killed one guy who you're still not sure was a terrorist, but you definitely killed 7 kids, I don't think righteous is the word I would use. You know, in fact, when you hear people use righteous, it's usually to justify terrible things that they know they've done. Like the Crusaders said they were righteous. You know, I also feel like we should never forget how easily our fear can drive us to do horrible things to other human beings. Because as terrible as this drone strike was, what's even more terrible is that when you look back at 20 years of the war, there's absolutely nothing unique about it.
The past several years in Afghanistan have seen a rise in the number of civilians killed. The first half of 2019 marked the first time that US and Afghan forces were responsible for more civilian deaths.
What makes it worse is that nobody ever seemed to face any consequences for these deaths, right? There's no other job in the world where you can just accidentally kill innocent people and then show up to work the next day like nothing happened, right? Nobody at the hair salon is ever like, "Hey, Vanessa, rough day today, but please remember for tomorrow, maybe use a little less conditioner and also try not to kill an entire family. Otherwise, great job. Yeah, see you tomorrow. Okay, bye." Because America's air war in Afghanistan was regularly killing civilians. And what happened? Was there a public outcry? Were charges filed? No. For the most part, no one even really cared. But to most people in America, this war became like when you forget Netflix is on, right? And then they have to pop up that little thing like, "Yo, are you still alive?" And best believe, the people of Afghanistan knew that the war was happening. Because to them, the terror of America's drone war was a part of everyday life.
Kareem Khan, who's from that tribal region, tells me his brother and son were killed in a drone strike in late 2009. He is suing the CIA, but given the chance, he says, he'd take revenge on those responsible.
"I will kill them. If Allah give me this opportunity, I will kill them because they are responsible for killing my brother and my son."
Forget being a 4-star general. Like, if you just watch kung fu movies, you would know this was inevitable. If you kill someone's family for no reason, they're gonna want revenge. And can you blame them for wanting revenge? Right? This is what anyone would feel. Any human would feel this. Imagine if, like, I don't know, let's say Norway blew up your house, killed your entire family. You'd be devastated. And I promise you now, it wouldn't make you feel any better if they told you they were actually trying to get some guy named Gary. You wouldn't be like, "Oh, you were trying to kill Gary. Oh, but you killed my family. Well, oh, no hard feelings. Good luck finding him. He sounds like a bad dude."